his car somewhere.
I think we're doing as good as we can, and I think the big question everybody's waiting to have answered is when are we going to start releasing the names of the people that are going to be appearing on each stage together with the permanent party? So I'm very excited by your plan to start rolling out publicity on the 1st of May, and the guy that just got knocked off is a huge, good publicist, and I'll just say what he would have said, which is we're going to ignore the mainstream media, we're going to go for the local media, and we're going to do a lot of radio.
Good. And yeah, we're starting the campaign on the 1st of May. And the idea is that because we've got hundreds of speakers, influencers, icons, advocates, people who are focused on analytics, stats, truth, disclosure, the whole gamut. This has to be Alpha Omega. We get one shot at this. This is the cavalry in that sense. And it's made up by the pulse of Middle America. It has to be made up by the pulse of Middle America. We've got many thousands of people on. I've got 2,500 people just on this room, which means we've got probably closer to 10,000 watching live. And those numbers will grow tenfold in the next few hours, guaranteed. Robert, let's speak quite unabashedly right now to the logistics of what we're doing. This costs money. I don't rattle cans. I haven't done for 23 years with the Humanitat Foundation, the New Earth, the University, the International Tribunal. I don't rattle cans. I'm rattling cans for this tour. Speak to us about the logistics and the hard costs.
Well, I have been absolutely stunned to raise $559,000. I've spent all of it. In fact, I'm $37,000 in the hole now. But at bigbatusa.org, there's a funding page that accounts in detail for every penny that I've spent. For example, we've already paid over $180,000 for $5 million buses of coaches. We've paid $47,000 for the racks. We've paid $50,000 and another $60,000 for two technical things. I just did a $57,000 deposit for 50% of the stage, the audio, and a generator so that we can do these things out in open fields. We are paying people to manage the websites, the emails, the certificates. Every donor of $100 to $110, and we use the 100, 101 is Michael Jaco, and then 2, 3, 4, 107 is Juan Osavin, and then you've got state assemblies, American patriots, and digital soldiers. So we're only asking for $100 donation. We will never ask for a second donation. We need to raise $250,000 in the next 30 days, but the big bills are paid through the 1st of June. However, we don't have enough money to compensate people that are actually doing this, including people like Trent Luce, who had to hire someone to replace himself on the farm, and other people like Lee Dundas are giving up major paying gigs in order to be on the tour. So bottom line, folks, is if you want this tour to be a complete success, we need your donations now as the tour is starting. And I would be very glad to see a spike come out of this show. This is a We the People tour. It is not being funded by sponsors, although we did get a couple of $50,000 donations. And, you know, I'm grateful for them. But this is about We the People paying for what is in essence a non-profit, non-partisan educational tour that shows the people that between constitutional sheriffs and election reform and blacks and whites coming together and the populist left, the populist right, the independents, libertarians coming together, we can take the power back. Join the fight. Ride for the USA. BigBatUSA.org. That's all I can do as one man.
Beautiful, Robert. Beautifully stated. Thank you very much. Just to underscore, I had Lee Dundas on. I saw her beautiful blonde face, her blonde. Hitherto, whenever we're looking over the horizon to be rescued from tyranny, we're looking for a cavalry. And the cavalry normally arrives. That's the hero's story. The cavalry usually arrives. But here's the thing. The cavalry normally belong to another prince or duke or king coming in to again gain supremacy and dominion over we the people. This cavalry must be funded by you. It must be funded by me, each of us. So people, make it happen. Make it happen. I'm going to ask, Scotty Sachs has joined us. Tell me you can hear us now, Scotty.
I hear you, Sasha.
Good. Scotty is
up. I'm energized by it. It's the first chance I have had to meet a number of you, including you, Sasha. All I can say is we're on the same page. And, you know, what's going to happen on this tour, this is going to be the game changer in the country. And I don't mean maybe. This is going to happen. This is real. This is happening. The talent that you've put together here, these people that have this kind of focus and this kind of mission focus, that one factor that all these movements lack is a mission focus, where people are unified on the same page. They're bringing the same message. We see the problem as the same thing. We've got to unite the country. We've got to get people over this idea that skin color matters, or the socioeconomic demographic is something that separates us, that all that stuff matters. At the end of the day, I believe when we're done, including the Native American people in this country, at the end of the day, we're Americans, period. And Reagan said it best. He said, we have every right to dream heroic.